Depression is a common and serious mood disorder that affects nearly 1 in 5 adults, or 19 million people in the United States. For these patients, the appropriate treatment may be life-saving, yet half of patients with depression will fail to respond to their first prescribed medication, leading patients on a medication odyssey of trial and error treatments that can last for years. Michael Genovese joins us this morning to discuss what the latest genetic testing breakthroughs mean for those faced with depression and mental illness. Good morning, Dr. Genovese.
Good morning, Chris. Thanks for having me.
Overall, how big a problem is depression today?
Well, it's a really big problem. You mentioned the numbers, and I don't think that many people realize it's that common. And it's a serious disease. Depression isn't just a case of the blues. Depression is low mood, the inability to enjoy oneself. It affects your concentration. It can affect your energy levels. And in worst case, it can end up in death. So we really need to optimize the way we're treating depression. And the good news is, we now have technology to help us do that.
And that was going to be my next question. What treatments are readily available for depression?
Well, there are a lot of medications out there that can be helpful in treating depression. The key is finding the right medication for the right person. This is truly personalized medicine when we're using the GeneSight test to look at your DNA, because I can look at your DNA and I can discern what medication is more likely to give you benefit and what medication is more likely to end up in side effects or not working. So it's a concrete, tangible way of giving me some information in order to help you.
And you mentioned side effects there. What are some of the side effects of medicines for depression?
Well, the most common side effects that I hear about are sedation, weight gain, upset stomach, sexual dysfunction, and they can be severe enough that it really prevents people from being able to take the medications. So by looking at what medication matches up with your DNA, we have a much better chance of getting you on a medication that you can tolerate. And if you can tolerate and stay on the medication, then we can get you better. It's a really great time to be in neuroscience.
Can you explain to us what is the GeneSight test?
Yeah, so it's a test that it's very easy to obtain in my office. It's a cheek swab. We send that sample off and get the results back in about 36 hours. And it's an easy test to show to a patient. It's a stoplight analogy with a red, yellow, and green column. We tell the patients that we're going to avoid the medicines in their red column, focus on the ones in their green column, and it benefits patients in a ratio of 2-to-1, patients get better twice as often using this test than without.
And which patients with depression are candidates for genetic testing?
I think everybody with depression should be asking their doctor about this test. You can go to genesight.com and get some information about the test and then go have that conversation. But in medicine, we want to have as much information as we can to help our patients. So having information is power, and we need that in combating this disease.
How do you use GeneSight testing in your practice to help your patients?
Oh, it's completely transformed the way I practice. Every patient that comes to me has virtually been on several medications. I use it for those patients right away so that I can effectuate the best treatment as soon as I possibly can.
Dr. Michael Genovese, thank you for joining us today. Some great insight into depression. Thank you.
Thank you for having me.